And what I'm telling that static variable
output of
always have a single or separate memory. Static memory not associated with objects. Remember this, okay? So this is the static memory. Now, this is OBJ1. OBJ2. And this is static memory, which is of J. Okay. Now, see, only J declared as a static, right?
Why?
Oh, sorry. Only Y declared as a static. I'm writing J. Wait. OBJ1. OBJ2 and Y, right? Now, see, when I make object 1 of this coding class, then what will be the value inside OBJ1? By default, I value is 0. You guys are right. But what will be the value in OBJ1?
100 high. I 100.
What?
Default value is 0. 0 replaced with 100.
No, just ignore 0. 5 and 100 default value. Matlab, in object 1, there is two value, 5 and 0. Whenever we create OBJ1, there is two value, which is 5, and OBJ1, we initialize I into 100. So 100. So this is the default value of OBJ1. What will the value of OBJ2?
0. 5.
Ignore 0. And? What? Only 5.
Oh, yes, 5.
Only 5 in OBJ2, but in Y
5,
but in Y what?
5
and OBJ1 dot Y
20,
because this is a static. So it contains 5 and 20, OBJ1 contains 5 and 100, and OBJ2 contain 5 only. Okay. Now, when we going to print OBJ2.i, to OBJ2.i will print what? 5. And then? After 5, next value. And then OBJ2.y. So what will be the value of OBJ2.y? OBJ2.y. It's 20. OBJ2.y. This object will access the value of y, which is 20 as per static. Okay. See this. If you guys are confused, see this. For static variable na, no need to perform any initialization. JVM will always provide default values. Okay, for static variable, no need to perform initialization. JVM will always provide default value. For example, if we write like this, class code static, for example, P, okay, and then public static void main, string and I'm going to print this value like this, system.out.println. What I'm going to print? The value of P simply. So you know what will be the output? Output of P?
0.
0. Good. So output is 0. So JVM always provide default value, which is 0 for static value. Okay, so yesterday I asked one question, or yesterday I'm talking about why Java is called pure or not pure object-oriented language. First, tell me, Java is pure object-oriented programming languages, or it is not pure object-oriented programming languages? Or why?
Not pure.
Not pure. So why you considered Java as not pure object-oriented language? Give me answer.
Because it doesn't provide support for multiple inheritance and operator overloading. And it uses primitive data types.
And it uses primitive data type. And primitive data type means what? Primitive data type,
like
example?
Integer, float type, like integer
string, type, float,
string, double.
Okay. So, okay.
Not string is not a primitive.
Let me tell you. In comparison with other language, like C++, Java has more object-oriented nature. It has more features of object-oriented. But somehow it's called not pure object-oriented languages because there are several features which are not supported by Java. Like you guys tell me, multiple inheritance are there, operating
pointers not supported,
overloading are there. So these are the features not supported by Java. But like if someone asks, is Java is pure objective programming language? Or like how we can consider a Java is pure object-oriented programming language? You just tell them because we are depending on primitive data tree. Because we are depending on primitive data type, we can convert it later. That's totally different thing. Like if you write like this, int I, this is primitive. Int is primitive. Char is primitive. Float is primitive. Okay, double is primitive. Long is primitive. So we can convert it later into wrapper class. I'll discuss it later. Okay. Internal reason will cover later, but for now, just we are depending on primitive data type, and these data type are non-object. And any language be called as pure object-oriented programming languages when everything is in the form of objects. Everything will be objects. Then only it is called pure object programming language. But here we are depending on primitive int. We are using this data type. Na? So for this reason only, or some more features are there also, Java is not considered as pure object oriented programming language. Okay. So for now, I'm going to end this class, and tomorrow, very important topic I'll discuss, which is command line argument and main method. Command line argument, which contains public, why we are using public, why we are using static, what is the mean of void, what is the mean of main? What is this string args? So everything we'll discuss tomorrow. So very important class is there. Command line argument. Okay. For now, I'm going to end this session. Thank you.
Thank you.